Hello and welcome to all. Today we shall read the third chapter of your NCERT book, Gopal and the Hilsa Fish. Children, do you like to read comic books? Which is your favorite cartoon character? First, let me tell you what is a comic book. A comic book is a series or sequence of drawings or pictorial representation to tell a story, mostly a fiction or a drama. The chapter 3 of your textbook is also a comic strip. It is the story of a witty courtier of a king. It is hilarious, funny, and shows the presence of mind of the central character Gopal and shows how he wins the heart of the king through his amusing act. Children, have you heard of Hilsa fish? It is a huge fish and people living in coastal areas are very fond of it. Now, let us have a look at the summary of the chapter and try to know its relevance and how it prompted a king to throw a challenge to one of his courtiers who accepted the challenge and what happened thereafter. It was the season for the Hilsa fish and everywhere in and out, each one of them was talking about the Hilsa fish. People were indulged in the buying and selling of the fish. One could hear nothing except the name of the Hilsa fish in all places. The king's palace seems to be no exception. One could hear nothing except about the Hilsa fish. And even in the court, all the courtiers were talking about nothing else but the Hilsa fish. They kept on discussing about it in front of the king. Everyone was curious to tell about the Hilsa fish to the king. Nobody seems to be bothered about anything else. Everyone is indulged in talking about the Hilsa fish. This annoys the king as he has to run the court and many other important things remain pending. No one pays attention to it. The king got frustrated and angry on hearing about the Hilsa fish all the time. He shouted at them but soon realized his mistake. He understood that it was the season of Hilsa fish and nobody could stop talking about it. Not even Gopal. Gopal was known for his witty answers and presence of mind. Gopal accepted the challenge from the king and said he could make people talk about other things too. The king knows that it is an impossible task, but he wanted to see how Gopal faces the challenge. The king challenged him to buy a Hilsa fish and to bring it to the court without anyone talking about it on the way. Gopal accepted the challenge and went back to his home. After a few days, he shaved his face half, smeared ash all over his body, and wore torn shabby clothes. His wife was surprised and anxiously asked him why he was doing so. Gopal calmly answered that he was going to buy a Hilsa fish. It was very astonishing for Gopal's wife to see him acting in a ridiculous manner and worried if her husband had gone mad. Gopal wore rags and set out to buy a Hilsa fish. His wife pleaded him not to go out in that manner. He told her to be quiet and went out of the house. His wife was puzzled and thought that he had gone mad. Gopal reached the market where everyone was looking at him in a puzzled way. They talked among themselves, why was a man dressed up shabbily and behaving in an improper manner? He bought a Hilsa fish from the market and started proceeding towards the palace. People on the way were very anxious to see a madman dressed in rags, half shaven and mud smashed all over his body. Children looked at him astonishingly and people all over talked about him. He reached the court and asked the guards to let him inside the palace. The guards scolded him and told him to go away as the king would not meet a person like him. To grab the king's attention towards him, Gopal started to make loud noises. Gopal started to dance and sing loudly. The king heard his voice and asked for him to be brought inside. Gopal was brought before the king. All the courtiers recognized him. They said that Gopal had gone mad and had lost his mind. They wondered why was Gopal behaving abruptly and in a strange manner. He was dressed in shabby clothes and sang loudly. Gopal had a strong image. He was known to be very intelligent and quick in his response. Gopal's appearance confused everyone and the king. King became curious to know why was Gopal playing such a prank. He demanded the correct reason what made Gopal to dress up ridiculously. Gopal reminded him of his challenge, which stated that no one would talk about the Hilsa fish on his way to the palace and not even in the court. He said that no one seemed to be interested in the Hilsa fish, which was in his hands. The king and everyone present in the court is amused. Immediately, the king remembered his challenge that he had thrown to Gopal and started laughing loudly. He was amused by Gopal's wittiness and his presence of mind. Everyone in the court laughed out loudly. Gopal had achieved impossible once again. For sure, nobody was talking about the Hilsa fish anymore. The king and everyone present in the court is amused. Immediately, the king remembered his challenge that he had thrown to Gopal and started laughing loudly. He was amused by Gopal's wittiness and his presence of mind. Everyone in the court laughed out loudly. Gopal had achieved impossible once again. For sure, nobody was talking about the Hilsa fish anymore. Hope you all liked the wonderful and funny story. Nothing is impossible if we try to achieve it. Have you ever experienced any situation where it seemed impossible to achieve the task? Please share the incident and let everyone know how you dealt with it. Till then, keep smiling and keep learning. Take care, all of you. God bless you all. We'll meet again with one more interesting topic. Bye-bye.